I am the only person in this country who contested 14 elections continuously without losing single election. I think at the age of 74, don't you think elder house is for people like us?
From being a grassroots youth Congress leader to leading his own national party, here's the story of how Sharad Pawar crafted his political career over 50 years through a series of rare interviews.
Do you have any regrets?
No. There is no question. I'm the happiest person. I'm the happiest person who is coming from a small family without any background, big background of the politics or anything.
Sharad Govindra Pawar was born in Maharashtra's Baramati in 1940. His family was involved in sugarcane farming.
He came from a very simple, humble family, and he's very proud of his roots. And I think they had a mother who had the vision, because two of my uncles in those days went abroad to study. My father just did a BCom.
He took to politics from a young age. At 18, he joined the Youth Congress and flourished under the mentorship of Maharashtra's first Chief Minister, Yashwantrao Chavan. He won his first election at the age of 27, winning the Baramati Assembly seat. His political clout grew as he gained control of sugar, textile and milk cooperatives. He was instrumental in building percolation tanks in the area and was able to turn the backward and dry Baramati into one of the most prosperous towns in western Maharashtra. Farmers grew cash crops like sugarcane and grapes, and several sugar mills were set up. This set the stage for Pawar's agriculture-oriented politics.
He is working for the people. Baramati Taluka has been progressed since 1967. So everybody has faith in him.
After the Indira Gandhi-led government lost the 1977 elections, Pawar joined the Congress U faction with Yashwantrao Chavan. He showed remarkable political shrewdness by breaking away from that faction in 1978 with a group of about 40 congressmen and forming a coalition government with the Janata Party. This made Pawar Maharashtra's youngest chief minister at the age of 38. Pawar returned to the Congress in 1987 when the Shiv Sena started gaining more ground in the state. In 1988, he was made Chief Minister again when the then Chief Minister Shankar Rao Chavan was made Union Finance Minister. He won the 1990 state elections and was sworn in as Chief Minister for the third time. When Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated in 1991, Pawar was among those considered for Prime Ministership. P.V. Narasimha Rao was elevated instead.
It was my duty to accept the decision and support him, and then I supported him. But it is true that I was very near. If anybody wants to become Prime Minister, he has to enjoy the support of substantial section in the Parliament, in the Lok Sabha. And unless and until that type of support is there, one should not expect that he or she will become she will reach to this position where he or she can lead the country.
Pawar was made Union Defence Minister and he is praised for opening up the defence forces to women. After Sudhakar Rao Naik stepped down as Maharashtra Chief Minister in the aftermath of the Bombay riots, Pawar was sworn in for the fourth time. Pawar's power run was cut short by Shiv Sena Supremo Bal Thackeray. The Sena-BJP alliance won the 1995 Maharashtra elections and Pawar became leader of opposition. Pawar continued to maintain friendly relations with Thackeray, showing that he had no permanent enemies in politics. A year later, he won the Baramati Lok Sabha seat and pivoted to national politics, looking to rise up the ranks of the Congress party. But his open disagreement during a Congress committee meeting in 1999 cost him his place in the party.
He raised the issue that the Bharatiya Janata Party might raise the issue in this election of her foreign birth. And she was eager to understand the views of her colleagues in the working committee. Overwhelming majority suggested that nothing will happen, we should not worry. I said it is true that BJP might raise this issue, but Sonia ji has contributed. After assassination of Rajiv Gandhi, it was just possible for her to leave this country and go back to Italy. But she never thought that she continued with this country. She associated herself with countrymen. And she also kept excellent rapport with rank and file in Congress party. And in such situation, in any way, raise the issue, we can definitely counter, so we need not worry.
The opinion was seen as a rebellion, and Pawar, P.A. Sangma, and Tariq Anwar were expelled. A few months later, they founded the Nationalist Congress Party.
You, at one stage, today as you are now talking, had left the Congress in a way. The NCP was formed over Sonia's foreign origins issue. Then you reached out to Sonia Gandhi and you're back with her. That's why people will ask this question.
You have forgotten the history. I have not left Congress. I have been expelled from Congress.
That's right.
Because I have given certain my views. That's why I have been expelled. But after expulsion also, when question comes to form government, I was having that number in my home state. If I were to go with NDA, India would have been formed government. We are not gone with India.
I take your point.
We supported Congress. Irrespective of that initial humiliation.
The NCP Congress Alliance formed the government in Maharashtra in 1999 and continued to rule undefeated for 15 years until 2014. Pawar was part of the UPA in 2004 and was named Union Agriculture Minister. At the same time, he was diagnosed with oral cancer, a result of a decades-long dependency on chewing betel nut. Despite health issues, Pawar worked on expanding his influence. In 2005, he became chief of India's richest and most powerful sporting body, the BCCI. He had earlier served as the president of the Mumbai Cricket Association.
Whenever I take interest in the sports organization, I never interfere in the sports. I do take responsibility to provide infrastructure, and I really enjoy and I get satisfaction from something creative.
As his assets grew, so did the severity of allegations against him. In 2006, he was accused in the wheat import scam. In 2009, of not being able to control sugar prices. And in 2010, spiraling vegetable prices.
I am saying there is a cartel of onion traders. And many say that this cartel is supported by parties like the NCP. That is where the charge against you and other leaders
is. That is absolutely irrational, illogical, unethical, and wrong.
Let's be honest, sir. Onion traders have had, in Maharashtra, had strong links with parties like you.
No.
Although Pawar was never formally charged in any case, all his political career he has had to battle the perception of being close to certain lobbies.
There are two images of Sharad Pawar, one connection with grassroots, one connection with big money.
No, but it's not a question of big money. For instance, Tata. If Tata is contributing for this nation, why should I oppose him? In fact, this is also achievement. They are also contributing for development of nation. And I'm not saying that because he has built up industry, that's why one should abuse him. This is not correct. I don't believe this.
On the political front, Pawar kept the Congress guessing. While he remained with the UPA, he kept his options open.
And I enjoyed this guessing the number of times, which I never heard, I never thought also, but I read in the newspaper, is that something is happening in my mind, which is news to me also, but I read in big column about that. What they write, and it happened something altogether different. Then they said it's difficult to predict Mr. Pawar.
In the 2014 elections, the NCP lost power both at the centre and in the state, and Pawar went back to being an opposition leader. He continued to hold friendly personal ties, even with his political rivals.
Ek baar main Israel unke saath gaya tha. Kafi din saath mein the. To mujhe ek baat batate the ki Modi ji, aap logon ka problem ye hai ki aap log image conscious zyada ho. Aap parwa mat karo, jo marzi pade karte raho. क्योंकि उनका अपना कन्विक्शन था कि भाई जो है सो है, मुझे करना है और मैं करते रहूंगा, और वे उसको खुल करके करने का स्वभाव रखते थे और करते थे.
We may have differed on some occasion, perhaps on many occasions, as any two individuals would do in a democratic system. But what has always been there, what has always been constant, is our respect for each other and the mutual belief that the legacy of our founding fathers should be protected, preserved, and promoted.
In 2017, he was awarded the Padma Vibhushan for his contribution to politics. Within 2 years, he announced his retirement from active politics to make way for his grandnephew, Shared Pawar. But that didn't pan out the way he had hoped, and it was clear that Pawar could not remain in the back seat for the 2019 Maharashtra Assembly elections. His leadership spirit remains strong, evident through this viral video of the then 78-year-old leader campaigning in the pouring rain. With no party being able to form the government on its own, Pawar showcased his political genius and changed the course of Maharashtra politics. He was able to drive a wedge between longtime allies Shiv Sena and BJP and convince the Sena to ally with the NCP. When his heir apparent, nephew Ajit Pawar, allied with the BJP and was sworn in as Deputy Chief Minister, Pawar still remained calm and confident.
Ajit Pawar formally returning, I think, to the Nationalist Congress Party camp this morning is the story to watch out for over the next 24 hours. Already all kinds of speculation is now doing the round. Was he a Trojan horse? From the NCP into the BJP camp, was all this, frankly speaking, the biggest Chanakya move which was made by someone like a Sharad Pawar?
The political grandmaster maneuvered an NCP Congress Shiv Sena alliance and formed the 2019 government. Pawar's deft handling of the situation showed that the Maratha warrior still has some fight in him.
Is there genuine heartburn that you've been done in by Sharad Pawar, perhaps on a game which was mastered by the BJP itself?
Pawar remains a leader with a legendary reputation. He has contested 14 elections and not lost a single one, a rare achievement that has eluded even former Prime Ministers Vajpayee and Indira. He is known as a shrewd negotiator and is praised for his ability to balance coalition politics.
Sir, are you ready to be part of a third front-like formation? You have a regional party. Do you believe that is the future?
No, I wish Congress. That's why.
You will not join such a regional formation?
So, my association will be with Congress. Tomorrow, if that type of situation comes, definitely I will say within Congress and UPA is that we should try to take near like-minded forces to form government.
So you will try and help the Congress tie up with more regional forces?
That's right.
He's known as one of India's foremost experts on the agricultural sector and even has a variety of grapes named after him.
He spends a lot of time in the farm. He has a little farm even in his home in Delhi where he grows his own vegetables.
The perception built around him notwithstanding, Pawar remains one of those old generation politicians who has shown he has the stomach for a fight. In his personal life, he has battled cancer. In his political life, he faced many a challenge to emerge unscathed. The Maratha strongman at 79 is showing no signs of throwing in the towel just yet.